We didn't imagine it then. The Premier League's reanimation may have been ghostly, muted, frantic, low-key, and oddly vague. But at Anfield, Liverpool drew themselves up to their full height and produced a performance that felt like muscle memory kicking in, like roots beginning to stir, that felt, above all, a bit like football. A 4-0 defeat of Crystal Palace leaves Jurgen Klopp's team a ludicrous 23 points clear at the top of the table. It was a reminder of something too. It wasn't a fever dream. Yes, they really are that good. It seemed fitting the moment of reignition should come from Trent Alexander-Arnold, a poster boy for many aspects of this team, from its rootsiness to the tactically progressive elements of Klopp's system. There has been a suggestion only the most natural footballers will be able to find their rhythm in these early comeback games. Well, this was exactly that from Alexander-Arnold, a performance of frictionless attacking excellence, and in the middle of it the re-engagement of his own evolving, deeply personal relationship with the position formerly known as right back. Before kick-off, it even seemed fitting the opposition manager should be Roy Hodgson. 10 years ago today, Hodgson was a week away from beginning his own ill-fated spell as Liverpool manager, with the club £351 million in debt classified by its own bankers as a toxic asset. Lockdown has been good to Roy. Palace's manager has emerged from confinement whippet thin and agreeably tousled, strolling the touchline like an aging roué returning at dawn from the casino table with only an ivory cigarette lighter and Mary Ann Faithful's phone number in his tuxedo pocket. Here Hodgson was still shaggy, but dreamier, as though someone had summoned the ghost of Keats from his laudanum slumber, propped him up in front of a board covered in adverts and demanded he talk in dreamy tones about Christian Benteke's thigh injury. Hodgson knows better than most how to organize against high-class possession-heavy teams. Here Palace were tightly stitched across the center. Early on, Andy Robertson tried a give and go and was crowded out by what seemed to be at least 200 men in white shirts. This wasn't so much attack v defense as a meeting of entirely opposed worldviews, neurotic introspection versus relentless alpha energy. It was only going one way. With 20 minutes gone, Palace conceded a free kick in a central area as Virgil van Dijk was bundled over. The ball was spotted slightly to the right, 30 yards out. At which point, for reasons that will remain obscure, there was a brief jostling match among the Liverpool players over who should take the kick. There is a pretty decent rule of thumb in these situations. 9 times out of 10, give it to Alexander-Arnold. The 10th time, think about it, then give it to Alexander-Arnold. It should be said this is based on future projections rather than past performance.